Well, Pan-STARRS is a relatively small telescope compared to the big ones we have on Mauna Kea, for example, but it has the biggest astronomical camera in the world, 1.5 billion pixels in the camera compared to your 10 million in your typical digital camera at home.
Pan-STARRS has surveyed the sky for over 4 years, and we're releasing all of that data, and that's millions of images and billions of objects in a database, and that'll be available for the whole world to use, for scientists, and even the public will be able to go in and download all those images.
If we had printed it in one giant image, it would cover an area of about 1.5 miles long.
What we're releasing is basic astronomical infrastructure. It's catalogs of stars and galaxies, and people will use that in a whole variety of ways that I can't even imagine now. It's a census of the universe, and the sorts of things that people will learn by digging into the details of that census will be enormous.
We've been mining the data set here at the University of Hawaii and in our collaborators' institutions to find specific things we're interested in, and those are looking for needles in haystacks. One in the 3 billion stars may be the most interesting thing to find. But our needle may be somebody else's haystack, and they want to find their own needles in the haystack. So by releasing the billions of objects in our database, people can go and do their own exploration. They can look for the things that they want to study themselves.
Discoveries that will come after this release will be, there'll be more of them than the ones that we've been doing over the past 4 or 5 years. And that's part of the point. This is a resource, it's a bonanza of data to be released that people, scientists, and people going through will be able to find a wealth of new things that we can't even imagine. That's why we're putting it out there.